Okay, well, one thing I thought I'd do today is give you an idea of some of the preparation efforts that have gone into getting these pieces of the Cougar ready to weld together. Today is the 5th of August, and last night I had another bronze pouring, and it was actually the last of the sections of the Cougar. Actually, this one right here, which is kind of a shoulder area, and then I've got this one, which is the opposite shoulder area. I've been doing a little bit of grinding on it today. I've got an angle grinder here. I've got another angle grinder here that has a cutoff wheel on it, and the wax sprue system that became bronze. I had to cut all of that away from the interior and exterior of the pieces, because obviously we don't want a bunch of bronze angular rods sticking out of this thing when it's all done. And we don't want to leave them in there because it's just a big waste of metal and excess weight. As it is, when this is all done, it's probably going to weigh very, very close to 200 pounds. And so that's going to become a consideration too, as far as how I go about the process of putting the whole thing together and which sections to put together when. Because once I do get the whole thing assembled, I still will have quite a bit of work to do on it. But at about 280 pounds, plus or minus about 7 pounds, well, more likely plus 7 pounds, it's going to be kind of difficult to maneuver and move around. And so I'm going to try to get a lot of work done, grinding, welding, etc., before putting the whole thing together. Now, I'm not going to abuse you too long with this grinding process because it is noisy, obnoxious, etc., etc. I'm wearing some safety goggles, and I also have a safety shield that I will be putting down. Try to get some of this, these little shards, very sharp little shards of bronze metal flakes that will be coming off with the grinding process. Keep those from getting in my eyes and stinging my skin and all that kind of stuff. Got my leather gloves to help protect me as I use the grinder. I've had to take the guards off the grinders because you just can't maneuver things around a piece of sculpture with the safety equipment in place. So all you shop teachers, just ignore that comment. And all you kiddies, don't try this at home. Okay, so as I said, I'm not going to abuse you too long with this because it is noisy, it is obnoxious, but I guess maybe this is my sympathy call, that you understand all this work that I have to go through and the noise and the labor of it all. It's 80 some degrees in this room right now, and I have to wear protective clothing, which makes me even less comfortable. But here we go. I've talked too much already. I'm going to loop this cord around me so it doesn't accidentally get in the way of the grinder. And there we go. Process is like. What I was actually grinding on is what's called flashings. Like here, if you can just see this bit of metal, it's from a very thin crack that kind of naturally occurs in the investment mold, and so it fills up with bronze. So I have to knock those away. Another thing that I do is right here, this is an edge that's going to be welded. I have to clean it up, make sure it's a good clean surface so that when I put the next section onto this, it's going to bond together really well and the metal's going to flow really well. So there we go. And again, give your ears a break, and what I'm going to do is shut off the camera and continue working.